Okay, then let's get started. Hi, welcome to my session about Apache Wicket and Ajax. What I want to show you today is that the basic Ajax stuff in Wicket is really easy, and if you want to go beyond that, it's not that hard either. What is Ajax? As you probably know, Ajax is an acronym, and it basically means JavaScript works now, like it always should have. It's a collection of stuff on the client side you can do with JavaScript, and then you have asynchronous requests where you can ask the server to give you more information, but this is asynchronous, it doesn't stop the user from using your application. So I have a short example how a normal browser request works compared to an Ajax request, because the Ajax request is really the stuff that Wicket is great with. Can you read this? The contrast is not very good. I should have tried that out before. A normal request looks like this. You are on a site. The browser displays you a page. You see the URL says you are on a site on the page foo, and then you request some navigation, like you submit a form or click a button. That means you send a request to the server. In this case, a GET request, and you request a page bar. The server processes this request. If you are using servlets, you implement the method doGet. You should not do this, but it boils down after you use a framework somewhere doGet gets called. And then after the server is complete processing the request, it sends a complete HTML page back to the browser, and the browser displays that page. An Ajax request is fundamentally different from that. You still have a page you are viewing, but on this page there is a piece of code, a JavaScript code, and the JavaScript code does the HTTP request. In this case, a GET request again. It's probably more likely to be a POST request when you're doing with Ajax, but it doesn't matter for this slide. And the server processes the request, but the server needs to know somehow that it is an Ajax request. So either the URL or some attributes in the request have to indicate that it is an Ajax request, because after processing, the server does not send a whole page back to the browser. It only sends some information that indicates what should be done after the request. And the script where the request originated has to know what to do with this information. So in this case, we tell the script, please add this text to the page. The script somehow knows how to do this and inserts the text. As you can see here, the user is still on the same page, so the page was not reloaded. From a browser perspective, nothing interesting happened. All was done by client-side JavaScript. Okay, and this Ajax request is something that Wicket makes easy to do. Most of the time, you only write a tiny piece of Java code and don't worry about everything else. Like, you don't write JavaScript, you don't worry about the communication, all that happens magically, at least in the simple cases. All right, now let's skip to behavior. As I said before, behaviors are the foundation for Ajax in Wicket. So what exactly is a behavior, or why would you need it? Imagine you use a component text field, but You probably want a text field for entering dates, or a text field with a certain CSS class, or a text field with HX validation, and well, whatever. There's a million of things you could want. So how could you implement that? You could use derived classes for every aspect that you could want, but then the inheritance hierarchy would become complicated, and you couldn't combine aspects. You could not use a text field with HX validation and a certain CSS class because we don't have multiple inheritance. You could put everything into a single class, which would become a bloated mess. So Wicket has pluggable behaviors. It's just a behavior is a class that can be added to any component. And then when you have added the behavior, the component will notify the behavior class before it renders, after it renders, when the model is bound, and on several other occasions. And the behavior can change the output of the component in every one of these lifecycle phases. If we have time at the end, I'll show you how you can implement your own behavior. All right, as I said, all HX stuff in Wicket is implemented using behaviors, and there's a base class for that. It's called Abstract HX Behavior, which really only provides some basic HX functionality. That is, it gives you a method named onRequest, and when an HX request is coming in, this method is called. You normally don't use the abstract HX behavior, but you'll use one of the predefined behaviors that come with Wicket. There's really a lot of them. A very useful one is HX event behavior, where you can register on any JavaScript event, like onClick, and then do something on the server side when this client-side event was fired. I already said that. And another nice one is the self-updating timer. This is an HX behavior which calls back the server in a regular interval. You just specify an interval, like a couple of seconds, and then you have to do nothing at all, because the self-updating timer just updates the component where the behavior was registered. But you can do something. You can implement the method on post-process target, where you can add additional logic to the updating. And that's our next code example. Okay, for this I'll add another component, another label. Because in this case I want a model that changes over time. So I'll add a new label. And I'll implement a model that is just a counter. Every time the value of the model is read, it will be incremented by one. So I didn't show you this before, but you can actually add any object as a model which implements the iModel interface. So in this case, I'll just implement it myself. I want an integer model, now I'll have to implement a couple of methods, and I should add a serial version UID, because a lot of stuff in Wicket is cached in the session, which can be a problem. You'll have to be aware of that, but that's not the topic of this talk. We don't care about detach, we don't care about set object, and in get object we'll want to increase a counter and return it. Okay, when I run this, I'll see a one here, and now we'll add a self-updating behavior. So the counter then really counts. Ajax self-updating timer behavior. And we want to call back every second. Let's make sure the context is reloaded. And then let's run it. So now the counter counts. That's just about everything I wanted to show you. What I want to take home from here is that there still are reasons why Wicket might be good for you, even though GSF is really great since version 2. It was a little bit hard to use before, but yeah. And that the Ajax stuff, or especially no matter what you're doing with Wicket, the easy stuff is really easy, and going beyond the easy stuff is most of the time not that hard. So please visit my blog, tell me how you liked it on Twitter or Google Plus, and if you have any questions, I'll be glad to answer them right now.